everybody stand. Thank you. time to heal, and it's a time to heal, it's a time to break down, a time to build up. It's a time to weep, and it's a time to laugh. It's a time to mourn, but surely there will be a time to dance again. The New Testament, the one you're hearing. John chapter 14 says, let not your heart be troubled. If you believe in God, it says, believe also in me. But my father's house is in many mansions, and if it were not so, I would have told you. Jesus says, I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, we may be also. Whether I go, you know, in the way, you know. Thomas answered and said unto him, how can we know the way? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes unto the Father except through me. God hates me. Father, we thank you for the opportunity to come before the presence. We are simply clay. Human vessels that approach your throne, we are not perfect. We mess up each and every day, but you, God, who are graceful and merciful, has kept us. Allow us another opportunity to go down this life journey. I pray, God, for every person that's on this side of my voice from crying to you today, because we need you. Family circle has been broken. Touching on this family and the reality of what they said this morning. Death has invaded their doors too frequently. But Lord, you, the song said that you were too wise to err, too just to be unkind. So with the devil meant for bad, you will turn it for good, and we trust you there. So we pray, God, that you will be a pillar of strength. You've been better to us than we've been to ourselves. We ask that you continue to be that. God, those who are with heavy hearts, let somebody know that they don't have to be holding me, and it's all right to cry. The Bible says that Jesus wept. So we pray, Lord, that they make this human. We pray, Lord, that as we are here, we will celebrate life. One of your children, that you allow us to be in this life for just a moment. Thank you for all the lessons, the experiences, sad times, but mostly we thank you for the joy that we have gained in our knowing you. It is in Jesus' name we pray. And the people of God come and shout together, amen. This time, we ask that Sister Kathy Jones come and bring unto us the selection safe with his arms. Thank you. things that we kept today. Moving to the Father's service, we got acknowledgments and expressions of love. Father Jim Wilson, your home establishment. Father, our families and friends, now the program says, thank you for expressions of tumors. You know, us as kids have problems at times, so we get past that tumor, so we're going to go to. Just before they come, could you help me thank God for this pastor, Reverend Dr. Gates, and the Tabernacle Baptist Church who has opened this reception this morning.
Can we give God a hand clap of praise? The family would like to have anything all of you to get acts of kindness and love shown to them during the past when they're loved ones. And to this family, on behalf of management and staff at J.O. Overton Funeral Establishment, understand that we can be endured for a night, but joy can be more. I was reading his obituary, and I see that he liked to move furniture with one of his good friends. And with moving furniture, you work for a moving company, or you move furniture on your own. And I want you to know that Mr. McDougal, his boss called him up one morning. And his boss called him and said, I think it's time for you to move furniture here, lady. And he's resting. And it is a blessing.
Oh,
opportunity to come before your presence. As we come before you, we just want to say thank you because in the midst of trials and tribulations, you've been good. You're worthy of praise from the rising of the sun. Scripture says it's going out of the sin, so you are truly worthy. We thank you now again for it is speaking time. Father, I pray, God, that people will hear all of your mind. Spark these lips of clay. Somehow may we encourage and uplift it. Thank you for all these things. It's in Jesus' name. Won't be before long. I want to read two texts of scripture coming out of the book of John, and also out of the book of Thessalonians. The book of John, chapter 9, verse 4. The New King James Version says, I must work the works of him who sent me while it is day. When night comes, no man can work. Thessalonians chapter 3. It says, our orders, starting at verse 6, our orders are backed up by the Master Jesus. Are to refuse to have anything to do with those among you who are lazy and refuse to work the way that we taught you. Don't permit them to be heroes and the rest. We showed you how to pull your weight when we were with you, so get on with it. We didn't sit around on our hands expecting others to take care of us. In fact, we worked with our fingers to the bone of half the night, moonlighting so that you wouldn't be burdened with taking care of us. It wasn't because we didn't have a right to your support. We did. We simply wanted to provide examples of diligence, hoping it would prove itself contagious. Don't you remember the rule that we had when we lived with you? If you don't work, you don't eat. If you don't work, you don't eat. I want to talk about a simple subject called hard work. We are people who are accustomed to hard work. Things don't necessarily come so easy to us. And even though we are in a time of generations who want things to come so easy, there were people before us who had to work hard just for us to live in the freedoms that we are experiencing today. We have the understanding that hard work will pay off if we put the time. Somebody used to say all the time, the old folks say, payday is coming after a while. The fact of the matter is, as a child growing up, you don't understand the efforts of hard work. We just simply asked mom and dad for money to get the things that we wanted while we were in the store, or simply when Christmas time would come, we would give them a list of items that we wanted. God knows, because I have 15, 14-year-old sons, we do understand that J's are not cheap. But it is seemingly that the children still do not have quite a grasp on understanding that there is a weight to be pulled. Mom, dad, grandma, granddaddy, aunt, uncle, somebody has pulled the weight in order to provide those 23s. Somebody worked hard for you. It's important that we teach, not only remind ourselves of the importance of sharing the load, but also to pass down to our children that yes, I'm going to get you the J's, yes, I'm going to get you the PS5, yes, the iPhone 13, but understand when I tell you, you got to wash them dishes You got to wash the dishes without complaining. I'm going to tell you that the bed got to be made up. You got to make the bed up. You know, I just bought the groceries. I'm not putting them up. You going to put them up. I just cooked the food. You going to wash the dishes. It's to teach them to understand that somebody had to put the work in. The scripture said it. I didn't say it. I read the text and you heard it. It says, do not allow the people to just continuously freedom only because the issue with us now so much of ourselves away that we don't have enough of ourselves for our own home. I've come to free somebody today that you don't have to feel weighted, guilty about anybody who's complaining about you not ripping and running. And I'm sure I'm talking to this family this week that you had plenty of people who wanted you to drag them here, drag them there, and you just want to call and tell them, did you not know I just lost somebody? Because the world is so full. You can tell and have the understanding that there are some things that, yes, we don't have to pay for because it was paid for us. And I'm certainly glad that one of those things is salvation. The scripture says that Jesus paid it all. He paid it all for me because he understood the scripture saying that yet while I was a sinner, Christ died for the ungodly. He died for you and me. I know they want to tell you that you got to cook enough chicken in the back to be saved, but that won't bring you salvation. I know they tell you to go to church every Sunday morning, but I'm here to tell you that won't even bring you salvation. I know they told you to give your money, give your tithe, give your offering, but that is not what saved you. Because if we could work hard enough to bring salvation to us, then what would have been the need of Jesus wasting his time dying? The place of work is so that we can share the load amongst each other so things won't be hard. In this time, it is so sad because the social media and the regular media will tell you that you have to exercise your own kingdom living. Everybody, all of us, you know, kings and queens, and so we feel as if we have to carry the load all by ourselves. When I was younger, you could go next door, and if you ran out of sugar, you could go get sugar from the neighbor's house. You could call up the street, your granny's house. We don't have bread, and you will share the load. It isn't that we all have the same gift with everything. You might work hard over here for one thing, and I work hard over here for another, and then we all bring what we have together to meet the need. It takes a family, it takes a village to raise children. That is the appetite and the mentality that we should have today. We should have the understanding that there is work to be done. But you cannot judge somebody for salvation because that is the work of Christ and he alone. The Bible says that if we call upon him, he'll answer. It says that if we believe in our hearts that God is raised from the dead, then we can be saved. I'm so glad I often tell people, according to Psalms 23, I like the text. It lets us know that still waters, and the Bible says that he restores my soul. And yet though I walk through a valley of light experience where I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I still fear no evil because he's with me. The Bible says, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. And this verse I love, he prepares a table for me in the presence of my enemies. I come back just for a moment to help you understand. Don't worry about what the haters or the naysayers say. Understand that the position and the place that they saw you in is not going to be the place they see you the next time. Because God says, even though, can I have it in King Dominic's interpretation, that even though you were eating noodles, and even though you couldn't afford the highest meal, it's tax season now, baby, I'm about to eat, but lay me up. To have an understanding that God is preparing a table for you in the presence of your enemies. If you work for God, the work that you do is not just for man, but it is to please God. to understand that if God has squeezed you, you don't got to worry about what anybody else says. The truth of the matter is people will talk about you. They're probably standing looking at me right now talking about me in their mind, but to have the understanding that I'm not here because I've been good, but I'm here because God's been so good to me. We're here because he's given us the opportunity to live again. You're here because he worked so hard. He lived a life and sacrificed for us so that we can get on the other side of through. I'm coming to my close, but I want you to know, I understand that, yes, your hearts may be heavy, and then your mind filled with so much pain and so many questions of why, but understand that it's some trusting in horses and some trust in chariots, but we must choose to trust in the name of the Lord. Brother Jerome is not in a place now where he has to suffer any more heartache or pain, don't have to suffer any more concerns to make sure everybody is taken care of, but he's in a state of rest now. He's in a place where the Bible says to be absent from this body is to be present with God. He's in a place where the Bible says that there is no more crying and there is no more pain. There is no more dying. And as a matter of fact, every day will be the Sabbath. That is to say that every day he can now take and rest from the burdens and wearies. And over here, there's a New Jerusalem. And then New Jerusalem, you're in the presence of the Almighty God. And in the presence of God, there's a fullness of joy. And at his right hands, there are pleasures forevermore. In God's kingdom, there are pearly white gates. You think you got money? He got so much money that the streets paved with gold. Over there, he told me in John chapter 14 that I'm going to receive a mansion over there in glory. And he said, if it were not so, I would have told you. I'm glad that he picked the time that when I'm stressing too much trouble in my body, trouble in my mind, and what the devil thought he was going to lap on us for bad, God said, I'll turn it for good. He's just escaped this mediocre life, a life where he is simply moral, to put on immortality. That means over there, there is nothing can stop him. The song says he's all the way up. Nothing can stop him. He's in a place where he's with the King of Kings, seated on the throne. And yes, again, nothing can stop him because he's all the way up. With God, there's no more trouble. There's no more trials. There's no man calling you 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. There's no more clocking in and out. But the work over here is done, and now I can receive the reward of the one who has called me into the earth. In the first place, he has called his name over in glory. And because he's there, he's worshiping with the angels. And my God, he's back again with the love of his life. And certainly they're saying, howdy, howdy, and holy, holy unto the Lord thou God. Because over there, there's a great celebration going on in the sky. I looked at the program and I saw and wanted to highlight this text that said, if you do not work, you don't eat. If you don't work, you don't eat. He was lifted up by his hard work, his efforts. The representative from the funeral home said it so nicely, that he was one time moving friendship, and God has now called him up to set the friendship of the sky. Bow your heads in prayer. Father, we thank you for the opportunity of your word. We thank you that even when we are in a place that we feel weak, we surround ourselves with our loved ones. But today, let the hurt, the pain, the trials, the frustration, even the unforgiveness roll out of the hearts of the people under the sound of my voice. Our strength may be there. We need you. You knew us from the beginning. You prepared us. You also said you would go away to prepare a place for us. If you go away, you said you'll come again and receive us to yourself, that where you are, we may be. So we thank you for allowing Jerome Earl McDougall to be in your presence today. We thank you for each one of his family members. I would remind them to work while it is day. We do understand when night comes, no man can work. That is to say, when our eyes is closed, the work here is finished. Help us to do what we can while we can. It's in Jesus' name we pray. And people of God say, amen. Receive it from our midst. For the friends of the family, please stand in the families who will remain seated.
To the